Hey, church kids and moms and dads, it's Mr. Damon, and I am so glad that you're here today. Do you know that you are a part of the Church Kids community, which includes kids from all around the world? That's right, countries all around the world. And you have an amazing opportunity to meet those other church kids and get to hang out with Church Kids pastors, because we have digital parties which take place every single week online. And to join, all you need to do is scan this cool little QR code on the screen right there to get started today.
Hey, Church Kids, it's Miss Lily. I'm so excited to be here with you on this incredible Sunday. How have you been? How has your week been? I want to hear about all of it. Well, Church Kids, I just recently came from an airplane to come back home. But you know what the best part about airplanes are? Especially when it's a long one and you gotta pass the time? It's movies. Who here loves movies? Raise your hand. Everyone? Anyone? I love movies. I don't think I've ever met anyone who doesn't like movies. Well, on the airplane, there were literally hundreds of movies that I could choose from. And I watched a couple here and there, but then I saw one of my favorite movies of all time. It was Monsters, Inc. Have you ever seen Monsters, Inc.? Oh my gosh, that movie is awesome. You have Mike Wazowski and J.P. Sullivan, and you got Boo. Oh my gosh, cute little Boo with your cute little pigtails. That movie's awesome. Why? Well, because they basically have to hide this human child from anyone else seeing, from the monsters, or else bad, bad things would happen. And it's basically Mike Wazowski and Sully's job to protect this little girl. Is that not such an awesome movie? And I want to hear some of your favorite movies. Can you just shout it out super loud so I can hear? Oh, yeah, Star Wars. Oh, that's a good one. Frozen? Oh my gosh, I love that movie. Oh my gosh, movies are the best. Well, what makes movies so incredible is a great story. In movies, there are heroes, there are main characters, and usually all of them go through really challenging things, or they have a mission that they have to accomplish. That is what makes a movie so awesome. It's not always easy, but at the very end, it makes us so happy. It makes us feel really motivated, like we're ready to go. That is the effect of movies. It's incredible. And just like our life, it's kind of like a story in a movie all on its own, because me and you, we have challenges that we go through too. And we have really awesome days and really hard days, but every single day we're pushing so that we have a better life. Kind of just like movies, it's crazy. And today we're gonna talk about the book of James. Because in the book of James, Jesus wants to tell us how to live and how when we trust in Jesus, we can grow our faith to then live the most incredible, amazing lives. Well, in the book of James, it was written by a guy named Billy Bob. No, I'm kidding. It was James, duh. James was actually Jesus's half-brother, and he was a leader in the church. But later on, he was actually killed because of his faith in Jesus, which is really sad. But he did some amazing, amazing things. About 15 to 30 years after Jesus died and rose from the dead and went back to heaven, there was a group of Christians who wanted to learn more about Jesus and wanted to learn more about how to live their best lives. Well, that's where James came in, and he wrote a letter to those Christians on how to live the way Jesus wanted them to live. It's crazy, because in life, we go through so many ups, woohoo, we're cheering, but also so many downs. And in the book of James, it teaches us how we can respond when we're feeling more of those down, sad days. Do we respond by maybe blaming someone else? Do we respond by complaining? I'm so angry. Maybe we respond by getting super frustrated or Hulk smashing things because we're so angry we didn't get what we wanted. Well, in the book of James, it teaches us how we can respond when we feel frustrated and sad and angry. And in James, it says, in verse 1 through 2, consider it a sheer gift, friends, when tests and challenges come at you from all sides. Wait a second. What? Are we learning that James is telling us that when we go through hard days, we have to look at it like a Christmas gift? I don't want to look at my hard days like a Christmas gift, but Jesus is telling us that we should. Why? Because those hard days really help build up our faith. And when we are able to trust in Jesus during those hard times, then our faith will grow so big that we won't even believe it. And in another verse in James 1, 3 through 4, it says, "You know that under pressure, your faith life is forced into the open and shows its true colors. So don't try to get out of anything prematurely. Let it do its work so you become mature and well-developed, not deficient in any way." Church kids, our faith grows in the toughest times. Have you ever been sad? Have you ever felt really angry? Well, it's much easier said than done, but when we are in those tough situations where we feel like we are helpless, we can't do anything to make it better, we want to trust in Jesus because Jesus is the one who wants to help you. He doesn't want you to feel sad. He doesn't want you to feel angry. He wants to help you so that you can grow from it and your faith will grow from it. And the second thing is that during those hardships, we want to be able to think about Jesus, not our problem. That is really, really tough because have you ever maybe had a birthday and you really wanted a certain gift, but you didn't get it? Like it's something that you were expecting and so excited about, but then you actually didn't get it. It's literally all you can think about, right? Or maybe you're in school and someone called you a mean name. You can't shake it off. It's kind of like in the back of your head for a really long time. Or maybe you had a soccer game and you tried to kick a goal, but then you missed and then your team lost. You can't forget about that. Well, church kids, whenever we think about our problem, guess what happens to our problem? This is our problem. We think about our problem, it gets bigger. We keep thinking about it, it gets bigger and bigger and bigger until it consumes us and our whole day is filled with us being so angry and mad. Jesus doesn't want us to live like that. So what happens when we have those problems? We want to think about Jesus and not the problem. Because when we think about Jesus and we trust Jesus, guess what? Our problems, they're this big. They'll get smaller and smaller and smaller because then Jesus is going to take care of those problems. And then we will feel like, I don't have to worry about those problems anymore. Why? Because Jesus is my best friend and he's gonna take care of all that stuff with me and for me. And the last thing is that Jesus wants to give us wisdom. He wants to give us wisdom when we don't really know how to respond to those certain situations. Again, we're feeling really angry, we're having a super bad day. We wanna ask Jesus for help. Jesus, please give me wisdom. How can I respond so that I'm better for the next time this happens to me, the next time I get in trouble from my mom or my dad? He wants to give you all of the wisdom. Church kids, I remember one time when I was a kid, I tried to make cookies for the first time, like plain chocolate chip cookies, pretty easy. But I didn't read the recipe right, and it became a giant pile of mush. I don't even think it baked. I think it was still raw and gross and definitely not edible with some eggshells in the whole mix. I was so mad because I was so excited about these cookies. But in reality, I just should have asked for help. I thought I could do it all by myself. But church kids, we can't do it by ourselves. We have never been able to do it by ourselves because we have a best friend and his name is Jesus. And that is what the book of James is all about. James wrote this letter so that we would be able to read it and learn how to live our best lives with Jesus as our best friend. He wants to be there for you. He will never leave you, never forsake you, because he loves you so, so much. So when we read the book of James, maybe it's when we're really sad or when we're feeling frustrated. That's the best time because then Jesus will speak to you in your heart and will be able to help you with those really, really big problems or with those challenges. But just like in movies, church kids, You know those heroes get through those challenges. You know those main characters defeat villains because they have their team, or they have their best friend, or they use their brain or their heart or whatever it is, Church Kids. We have something like that too in our own lives, in our own movies. And that person is Jesus. So when we talk to Jesus, ask him for wisdom, ask him for help, ask him to be our best friend forever, then all of our problems, we get to fight alongside with Jesus as our best friend.
Wasn't that an amazing message, Church Kids? One of the most powerful things that you and I can do to grow our best friendship with Jesus is to connect with and build friendships with other Church Kids. It's true. And you have an opportunity to do just that by joining our digital parties, which are taking place every single week. So go ahead and ask your mom and dad to scan this QR code to get started today. And we'll see you next time.